A recent study shows that social media remains to be the top source of news in the Philippines. But the same study shows that Filipinos are getting their information from a more recent entry in the social media space. Katrina Domingo reports.
Many Filipinos are preferring to consume news on their digital devices using social media platforms like YouTube to get information on important events instead of more traditional sources like television and radio.
Sa panahon ngayon, puro internet na, puro social media. Kaya doon na lang po nakakasagap ng balita. Nakakalimutan na yung mga dating technology tulad ng TV, yung may antena pa. Ngayon puro Wi-Fi na kasi.
Mas mabilis sa YouTube kasi marami natin pagpipilian na mga TV network.
The 2024 Digital News Report from the Reuters Institute shows that social media remains to be the top news source for Filipinos. And while Facebook still takes more than half of the pie, the number of Filipinos who rely on it for news has dipped. The same goes for other sites and apps like YouTube, Facebook Messenger, Instagram, and X. But it's a different story for TikTok, as the Chinese-made app continues to gain popularity in the Philippines, even for news content. University of the Philippines Journalism and Communications Professor Danilo Arao explains, Filipino audiences now prefer watching short clips over consuming lengthy videos or reading.
Ang tawag na yata ng kabataan ngayon doon ay snackable, yung parang digested na.
For sociologist Ash Presto, the two-way communication feature of social media apps is another factor why Filipinos, especially the youth, prefer these over traditional sources of news.
Kasi if you look at TikTok, social media, yung comment section, doon nag-i-interact yung mga tao. That is not available freely for traditional media na parang i-consume mo lang siya pero hindi two-way yung interaction.
She adds, a viewer has more freedom on social media as he or she can curate what appears on his or her feed.
Oh, this is interesting because it shows you that social media, increasing social media consumption is not altogether negative. So it also fosters more critical audience na nag-gravitate towards more critical opinion makers on social media.
While the number of Filipinos consuming news through social media continues to increase, 63% of the 2,100 Filipinos surveyed said that they are still worried over misinformation on the web. This is why experts say that the challenge for journalists nowadays is to find more ways to tell relevant stories in these new platforms.
Kaya yung challenge talaga sa social media organizations would be to maximize yung kanilang social media platform at yung ililink nila yung kanilang website sa kanilang social media platform. So hindi tayo dapat mag-alala na ito na yung pagkamatay ng mga traditional websites or blogs. Hindi pa po mangyayari yon. At ako, imposibleng mangyari yon.
Experts also remind the public to be more critical when consuming news and information online, especially if these are from dubious sources or anonymous accounts. At least one analyst is calling on journalists to act urgently in fighting misinformation, noting that the Filipino public appears to have taken for granted the importance of news. Veteran journalist Virgel Santos also believes media should take advantage of new technologies like artificial intelligence to enhance the profession and make news contents more appealing to the modern audience. Katrina Domingo, ABS-CBN News.
A new revelation on the possible true identity of suspended Bamban Mayor Alice Go. Senator Sherwin Gatchalian bared on Tuesday a photo showing the passport of a certain Go Hua Ping. Gatchalian is convinced this is the real name of Alice Go, and her real mother is indeed Chinese national Lin Wen Yi. Go has insisted her biological mother is Amelia Lial, the Filipino house helper of her father.
Kumbinsido ako na si Go Hua Ping ay si Alice Go. Iisa lang yan. Tingin ko kaya hindi niya maikwento yung kanyang childhood, yung kanyang kabataan dahil hindi siya lumaki dito.
Totoo.
At kaya walang records ng kanyang birth kung saan siya ipinanganak dahil hindi siya ipinanganak dito. Kung makikita natin, hawig na hawig nung batang malaki si Alice Go. Itong si Go Hua Ping, hawig na hawig.
Gatchalian also believes the new discovery may lead to Go's removal from her post.
yung pagsisinungaling niya sa Senado na completely wala siyang alam, iyang patunay na dahil hindi nga siya lumaki dito, dahil nagsinungaling siya, itong mga ebidensya na ito magagamit na ngayon ng Office of the Solicitor General sa pagfa-file ng co-warranto case para unang-una matanggal siya sa pwesto. Tingnan natin buong picture. Nalusutan tayo ng isang peking Pilipino na nakatakbo bilang mayor. At kung hindi pa natin na-detekto, pwedeng maging congressman, pwedeng maging governor.
The Presidential Anti-Organized Crime Commission is determined to take Go to court. Aside from human trafficking charges linked to the Pogo compound in Bamban, PAOC says it also has evidence of Go's connection with the illegal Pogo hub in Porac, Pampanga.
We believe that she remains the beneficial owner of Baofu Land Development, that she was not only connected with Baofu, but with the actual operation of the Pogo itself, even after divesting. Ang Bamban at saka Porac, ang lagi namin sinasabi, sila po ay dalawang sanga ng iisang puno. That Mayor Alice is part of the same criminal organization that operated both Bamban and Porac.
Go has written a letter to PAOC Chairman Executive Secretary Lucas Bersamin appealing for a fair probe into her controversies.